Greetings of the day, dear children. Today we are starting with our exercise 2.2 again, question number 4, chapter number 2, whole numbers. Now, in question number 2, what they are saying, find the product using suitable properties. Now, here in this question, they have specifically asked us about the property. So, let us start. I am doing first part over here, 738 multiplied by 103. So how to do it? Now here, as with the help of our properties video, you will come to know how to do it, which property we should use. So what we are going to do, we need to expand one of the numbers so that we will be able to solve it more easily. Now you can see here, I have expanded 103 in this form, 100 plus 3. 103 can be written in this form. This property is known as distributive property. How to do it? In our property video, we have understood it. What we will do, we'll multiply these two numbers, as 738 is common for these two numbers. So what we are going to do, multiply 738 by 100, then put this addition sign, and then we multiply 738 again with this 3. Why we have done this? Now here you can see it was difficult for us to do the multiplication of these two numbers, but if you can see here, we just have to multiply 738 by 100, we'll get the answer same by adding the two zeros, and we'll multiply 3 with this number, so it can be done orally also. You will multiply 738 by 3, you will get the answer. Now we just need to add these two numbers and we'll get the desired result. Now here, four parts are there in the question. I have taken the D part, and the remaining two parts, dear children, you will do on it on your own. Now what does the D part says? In D part, 1500 is given and 168 is given. You can expend any number of your choice. Here I have expended 1005 because by expending this number, my calculation will become easy. So 1000 plus 5 can be written as 1005, same property, distributive property we are using, and then we need to multiply it with 168. Multiply 1000 with 168 first, and then put this addition sign, and then multiply 5 with this 168. When you multiply, you will get your answer, and then we need to add. This is our D part of question 4. The remaining two parts you will do on your own. Now let us move ahead with question number 5. A taxi driver filled his car petrol with 40 liters of petrol on Monday. The next day he filled the tank with 50 liters of petrol. If the petrol cost 44 liters, how much did he spend on all? Now you need to understand the question first. What the question is saying, there is a taxi driver who spent 40 liters of petrol on Monday, means car was filled with 40 liters on Monday, and the other day it was filled with 50 liters. The rate of petrol remains the same on both the days, that is 44. We need to find out the total cost. So how to do this question? As you can see, first you need to write the statement. Petrol filled in car on Monday is 40 liter. Petrol filled in car on next day is 50 liter. And what is the cost of petrol given? It is given 44. Now 44 rupees is per liter. Means 1 liter costs 44. So on Monday, how much cost, how much money he might have spent? It will be 40 multiplied by 40. 44 multiplied by 40, because cost of 1 liter is 44 and the total liters is 40 for Monday. Then on next day, again 44 is for one day and 50 liters was filled. So we'll multiply these two numbers. Again, how you will solve this question, children, don't need to multiply and then add. We will apply the distributive property. If you can see, this cost 44 is same for both the days, so I have taken it common, and then in bracket whatever number is left, I have put those number in bracket. Here 40 was left, this plus sign, and then 50 was left. Now what I am going to do, I'll add these two numbers first, and then I will multiply this number and I will get my answer. See how quickly it was to solve the question with the help of the property. So this was your question number 5. Let us move ahead with question number 6. A vendor supplies 32 liters of milk to a hotel in the morning and 68 liters of milk in the evening. If the milk costs 45 per liter, how much money is due to the vendor per day? Now again, cost of milk remains the same. The liters of milk supplied in the morning is 32 and in the evening it is 68. So how we will do? Again, same process. Milk supplied in the morning is 32. Milk supplied in the evening is 68. And the cost of milk is 45 per liter. Money due to vendor is, cost per liter is 45. We'll multiply it with 32 and then add, and then we'll multiply 45 again with 68. Here you can see 45 is common, the cost was common. So 45 I have taken common, and in bracket the numbers which are left were 32 and 68. I have put them in bracket. Simply what I will do, first I'll add those numbers, that is it will become 100, and therefore the total cost is 4500. See, if I need to multiply these two numbers and these two numbers, the calculation might become difficult, and then I need to do the addition also. Here I have just added and multiplied in two steps, my answer is there. So this is a shortcut, that is why we use the property. This is your question number 6. Let us move ahead with question number 7. Question number 7 to be done in book itself. What is question number 7 saying? Properties name are written over here on one side, and the solution simplification is written on the other side. We just need to add with the properties name. Now here you can see 425 multiplied by 136. How they have done? 425 multiplied by 6 plus 30 plus 100. They have expanded. Just now we have used this property. So which is this property? This property we will term as distributive of multiplication over addition, because over addition we have distributed the multiplication. So this C part is our first answer. Here 2 multiplied by 49 multiplied by 50 is written, and then they have just shuffled up the places of the numbers. So this we have studied. This is our commutative under multiplication. The property name is commutative, and we are doing the multiplication over here. So answer will be commutative under multiplication. Same goes for your third part. In third part, you can see 80 plus 2005 plus 20 is equal to 80 plus 20 plus 2005. Again, the shuffling of the places is there, and it is the B part is only left. So this is known as the commutative under addition. So this is your question number 7. By this, we have come to the end of exercise 2.2. I hope the exercise is clear to you.